Okay, this video is brought to you by Brilliant at Work. If you're looking for a place to learn how to solve interesting and challenging math questions, you will love Brilliant at Work because they have this problem solving section where they give you new questions each every week, ranging from basic to advanced. And some of the questions are really hard and you are going to have a lot of fun solving them. And most likely, you're going to spend a lot of time working on the questions, but once you solve them, the feeling is just so amazing. And you guys can also check out their courses. They offer courses in calculus, number theory, probability, discrete math, and a lot more. You guys will have a lot of fun working on their questions and reading through their courses. And if you guys are interested to sign up for the annual premium subscription, be sure you guys use the link blackpenredpen because this way you guys can get a 20% off discount if you are the first 200 people to sign up for the site. And today I'll show you guys something that you're not going to see from your calculus textbooks, namely the DI method for integration by parts. And a lot of people think that the DI method is just like magic because it works out so magically, right? But it's actually not magic. It's just integration by parts. But it's a really, really convenient way for us to set up and do the work, and it's really easy for us to remember what to do. So I will first tell you guys the traditional format right here, the UDV format, and then I will show you guys the DI format right here. Both of them are just integration by parts. And if you guys want to see the idea behind integration by parts, you guys can check out the video in the description. Anyway, we are going to integrate x squared times cosine x dx. And to do this, we have to use integration by parts, which says we have to break this down into two parts. One part to be differentiated, and that's the u part, and the other part to be integrated, and that's the dv part. And you should always choose the part to be integrated because it's always harder to integrate, right? So I'm going to pick cosine x dx to be integrated, and we'll just put down x squared to be differentiated. And once we make our selection, just go ahead from here, differentiate. We get du is equal to 2x dx, and then we integrate both sides. We get phi equals to the integral of cosine x is equal to positive sine x. Be careful with that. And now we have our ingredients. And the formula of the integration by parts says this integral is equal to u phi minus the integral of phi du. You don't have to remember the formula because if you set it up like this, all you have to remember is that just multiply this and that. And this is how you get the u phi. And that's the first part of the answer already. So we put down x squared times sine x right here. And you just have to remember, we are going to minus another integral. Notice, I put down this minus in blue. You will see why. Minus another integral, and this integral comes from the product of this and that. So you see, we have the 2x right here, and then the sine x right here, and of course, we put down dx all the way at the end. So now you see, this integral, the original one, it's equal to x squared times sine x minus another integral, which is the 2x times sine x dx right here. Check this out though. We are making progress because we have the first part of the answer already. And this integral is actually easier than the original one. But this integral still requires integration by parts. Well, let's go ahead, pick something to be differentiated and something else to be integrated. I will pick sine x dx to be integrated, and then I'll put down the 2x to be differentiated. And once we make our selection, go ahead, du is equal to 2 dx. Integrate both sides. Integral of sine x is negative cosine x. Be really careful. So to do the integration by parts for this integral, once again, just multiply the product of this diagonal, which we have the 2x times negative cosine x. And notice, I put all this in a big parenthesis for the result of this integral, okay? And the integration by parts for this integral says we will have to subtract another integral. So I have the subtraction here. This integral comes from the product of this and that. So we get the 2 times cosine x dx. All of this are inside of this big parenthesis. Of course, you see that we have the minus times this minus, you can distribute. So you have minus this, and then minus times minus, this is going to give us a plus. We have another integral right here. And some of you guys can see that we can bring the 2 to the front and just integrate negative cosine x. That's fine. But the truth is, I can look at this and do integration by parts again. just to show you guys the consistency. I will pick U to be 2, and then du to be this. And when I differentiate u, I get 0 this time because u was just a number 2. And when I integrate dv, when I integrate negative cosine x dx, I get v equals to negative sine x. And now you see, if I apply the integration by part formula, I will do this diagonal, this times that, which is 2 times negative sine x, and that's the part of the answer already. And I will have to subtract an integral, which is going to be this times that. But since this is 0, so I don't have anything else to do. I don't need to minus integral of 0. That's just going to give us a constant. So as you guys can see, we are pretty much done. In the end, we just write everything nicely. Here is x squared times x, negative times negative, it's positive. 2x cosine x, and then positive times negative is negative, 2 sine x. And then in the end, we have the plus c. So this is the answer for the original integral, and we are done. Then this is the traditional u dv format. It's a lot of little things to write, and a lot of parentheses to take care of, and things like that. And of course, this is one of the reasons why that people don't like integration by parts. But don't worry, because right now, I'll show you guys the DI method, the DI format, the DI setup, whichever way that you want to call it. But you have to remember, we are still doing integration by parts. So you have to remember that for integration by parts, we are going to break down this original integral into two parts. The first part is to be differentiated. The second part is to be integrated. And this is why I got the name, the D and an I. I'm going to pick something to be differentiated and then something else to be integrated. And you should always choose the part to be integrated first because it's always harder to integrate. And we are going to select cosine x. You don't have to put on dx right here, just put on cosine x, it's fine. And I will pick x squared to be differentiated. So if you guys see, x squared times cosine x, that was pretty much our original integral. And the original integral was positive. So right here on the side, let's put down the plus. And once we put this down, let's just go ahead and do the work. Let's integrate cosine x. We get positive sine x because we're integrating cosine. And right here, let's differentiate x squared. We have 2x. And this is nice. So as you guys can see, this is pretty much the u, and this is pretty much the dv. And then we still do the work. And to get the first part of the answer, we just have to do the product of this diagonal, namely positive x squared times sine x. And that's the first part of the answer, and that's it. How wonderful, isn't it? So let me write down x squared times sine x. That's the first part of the answer. And remember, the formula says we have to subtract another integral. We have to subtract the integral of the product of this and that. Well, this is the reason why I told you guys you have to put a plus minus on the side. This minus was because of the formula says so. And you have to remember we are going to minus the integral of this and that. But this is exactly what we had right here. And requires another integration by parts. I'm sorry. And requires another DI method, isn't it? And if I want to do the DI method for this integral, in fact, I can just use the same one. I will just be differentiating 2x because you see, I differentiated 2x earlier. And this 2x was from here. So we can pretty much keep differentiating the things that you pick for the D column. And of course, similarly, you can also keep integrating this. And that's pretty much it. So let me do that. Integrating sine x, we get negative cosine x. Differentiating 2x, we get 2. So once you do that, you can see we just multiply this diagonal, and that's the second part of the answer. Be sure you attach the sign. Negative 2x times negative cosine x. And this right here is precisely what we did right here, isn't it? So of course, you guys can see that the format's much better. And when you do this times that, it's plus 2x times cosine x. And now, the product of this rule is another integral. We should subtract. But this integral is inside of the previous integral. This subtraction was inside of the previous subtraction. And if you distribute the negative, negative times negative, of course, we get a positive. This is why we have to alternate the sides on the side, the plus minus signs on the side. So this one is positive. So we have the next integral, which is plus the integral of this times that. But you can use the same format. Do it again. Differentiating 2, we get 0. Integrating negative cosine x, we get negative sine x. So we just put it here. And again, we just do this times that. And this is the third part of our answer. This is positive 2 times negative sine, which is negative 2 sine x. And in fact, we are done. Because if you keep differentiating this right here, you just get a bunch of zeros. And right here, if you keep integrating, well, the next term is just going to be 0 times whatever that is, which is 0. And of course, the next term is going to be 0 times whatever that is, which is still 0, and so on. So stop right here when you see a 0 in the D column. And in fact, this is the first stop if you're using the DI format. Once again, when you see a 0 in the D column, you stop right here. And the idea is that this is technically going to be, you see the plus minus plus, so it should be a minus here. We have to minus another integral, and that's going to be 0 times this, which is 0. The integral of 0 is just a constant, and if you are saying minus a constant, doesn't really matter, you can just put on plus constant. So we are done right here, and this is pretty much the answer. Of course, it's the same as that. Earlier, we did a lot of this right here for the traditional format, but for the DI format, it's just this much. In the end, we put down plus C and box the answer, of course. This right here is it. How wonderful this is, right? So hopefully you guys all like this video, and this is actually just the first step for doing the DI format. There are two more. Be sure you guys watch my other video for the two other stops. And don't forget to check out blackpenredpen as well, because I believe that will be a wonderful way for you guys to really improve your math skills. And this way you guys can also help me to grow my channel, and I can also do more teacher giveaway for you guys. But anyway, as always, this is it.